Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another video on Next.js learning. In this video, we will take a step further and learn about linking and navigation, dynamic routes and route groups. I will try to keep things as simple as possible. I am still learning, so please feel free to correct me. You can comment here or DM me on my social media handles. The links are down below in the description. So without wasting more time, let's get started. We will start with linking and navigation. There are two ways to navigate between routes in Next.js: using the link component, using the useRouter hook. We will see the use case of both the link component and the useRouter hook. First, we have the link component. It is the primary way to navigate between routes in Next.js. In order to use this component, we have to import the link component from next/link and later pass a href prop to the component. So make changes to our code according to the official docs. We are learning these basics right now. Later, we will use this in building a major project like e-commerce. I am placing the copied code in the root page.js file so that I could get the dashboard navigation link on the home screen, which is running on a 3000 port. Save the file. Now when you go to the tab where our project is running, you can see that a dashboard link is rendering. When you click on this link, you will be navigated to the dashboard screen. Simple, isn't it? Sometimes we have to generate a list of links. For example, let's suppose you are building a blog website. Now for each title, you have to generate a link, right? Each title should be displayed on the blog website. In these type of cases, the dynamic segment of linking comes in handy. Also, while building blog web apps, sometimes few links are active, few are not. In this case, the Next.js provide a use pathname property to determine if a link is active. You can just inspect this code for now. We will try to implement all these while building a blog website soon. Next.js also provides the feature of scrolling to an ID. What this means is, let me explain. You can see the URL link of this Next.js docs right now, right? The default behavior of the page is to scroll to the top of a new route. If you like to navigate to the specific ID on navigation, then you can do it easily. Let's add this to our project. This property is more visible on a page that has a lots of topic with links. But for the basics overview, this showcase is fine. The default behavior of the Next.js app router is to scroll to the top of a new route or to maintain the scroll position for backwards and forwards navigation. If you would like to disable this behavior, you can pass scroll equals false to the link component. Next, we have useRouter hook. The useRouter hook allows you to programmatically change routes. Let's add this hook to our project. First, we have to import this hook. Then in return section, we will implement this hook inside a button. This looks cool. When you click on this, of course it will navigate you to the dashboard page. Okay, we got an error. The best part of the Next.js, when you click on the error, it will give you detailed information about the error. Here we have reference error because I failed to define the router. Perfect. Now it's working as expected. Now if you want to navigate to the settings page on the button click and add /settings inside the button, then it will show an error. Why? Because the settings router is added inside the dashboard router. So to navigate to the settings page, we have to use /dashboard/settings inside the button. Next, how routing and navigation works. When a user navigates to a new router, the browser doesn't reload the page, and only the route segments that change re-render. improving the navigation experience and performance. The Next.js uses prefetch and caches for this. Prefetching is a way to preload a route in the background before the user visits it. There are two ways routes are prefetched in Next.js: link component and router.prefetch method. For example, let's say you have a product listing page and a product details page. When a user hovers over a product on the listing page, you can use router.prefetch to preload the product details page in the background. This means that if the user decides to click on the product, the details page will load more quickly. The prefetching of the static route is by default set to true, but the prefetching of the dynamic route is a bit different in the Next.js. By default, only a portion of the route's content is prefetched and cached. This portion includes the shared layout of the page and extends until the first loading.js file. This is done by optimizing the performance and reduce the cost of prefetching for dynamic routes. Additionally, the prefetched content is cached for 30 seconds to further enhance the user experience. You can disable prefetching by setting the prefetch prop to false. Also keep in mind that prefetching is not enabled in development, it is only enabled in production. Caching is a technique used to store frequently accessed data in a temporary storage space for quickly retrieval. In the context of Next.js, caching plays a significant role in optimizing the performance of our application. Imagine you have a blog website where users can browse different articles. As a user clicks on various articles, the content of these articles could be cached in the router cache. So if the user goes back to an article they have previously visited, instead of fetching the article content again from the server, the app can retrieve it from the cache. This not only reduces the number of requests sent to the server, but also minimizes the amount of data transferred over the network. Partial rendering is a technique that focuses on re-rendering only the specific parts of a web page that have changed, rather than the entire page. This approach enhances performance by optimizing the work needed to update the display. Next.js takes a different approach known as soft navigation. When you navigate between pages within a Next.js application, the app router uses soft navigation. In soft navigation, React only re-renders the segment of the page that have changed, while preserving both the React state and the browser state. This means that there is no full page reload, resulting in a smoother and faster user experience. In hard navigation, the browser reloads the entire page. By default, when a user navigates backward and forward using the browser's navigation button, Next.js maintains the scroll position. This means that if a user scrolls down an article on the home page and then clicks on a link to view another article, when they go back to the home page using the browser's back button, they will return to the exact scroll position where they left off. Next, we have route groups. Using route groups in your application's directory structure allows you to organize your routes into logical groups without altering the URL path structure. This gives you the flexibility to create different layouts for different groups or sections of your app, enhancing the overall user experience. Let's see an example. Add an account and a cart group into a shop group. You can see that I don't have to include the shop name in the URL. We can smoothly navigate to the cart and account page. Yes, you can also add the layout for each route inside the shop group. You can also add the layout inside the shop group to make a different layout for the shop section. it is clearly mentioned that to create multiple route layouts, you need to remove the top level layout.js file and add a layout.js file inside each route group. This is useful for partitioning an application into sections that have a completely different UI or experience. The HTML and body tags need to be added to each route layout, so keep this in mind. Don't forget to read the Good to Know section, it has some amazing brainstorming facts. At last, we will do some digging on the dynamic routes. Dynamic routes in Next.js allow you to create pages with URLs that depend on specific data. This is particularly useful when you have pages that share a common structure but vary based on the content they display. A dynamic segment can be created by wrapping a folder's name in square brackets. Let's take an example of a blog website. A blog could include the following route: app:\blog\square bracket slug\square bracket close\page.js, where square bracket slug is the dynamic segment for a blog post. Let's add this to our project. Okay, we got a runtime error. Because our layout.js page is empty in the cart section, simply just add one basic layout.js code we used earlier. And here we go. It is working fine now. But we are here to check the dynamic routes of the blog website. So let's test it out. You can see that the post is changing as per the URL we provide. This is because of the dynamic routing property of the Next.js. Next up, we have generating static params and catch-all segments. You can read more about these here in these official docs if you want, but you will be more familiar with these concepts when we will make a full-fledged web app like e-commerce. So stay tuned for that. That's it for this video. In this video, we learned about linking and navigation, dynamic routes and route groups. We saw how to implement these concepts in our project. If I made any mistakes or you have a better way to approach the problem, please don't hesitate to comment here or reach out to me on my social media handles. And yes, I will continue to make videos on Next.js learning, so make sure to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching and see you soon.